and Chitra Devi, working as a assistant professor in Pratyusha Engineering College, Mathematics Department. Now I have to take the topic is Laplace transform. This Laplace transform is very useful for linear differential equation to ordinary differential equation. Okay. Now my topic is the convolution theorem. So what is the convolution theorem? See here. What is the convolution theorem? First, now I have to write the formula. Here you can take the function, the two function f of t, g of t. So this is denoted by f of t and g of t is nothing but you have to put the integral 0 to t. The first function you have to replace u. Okay. So here you can take f of u. The second function g of t you have to replace t minus u. Okay. So here you can take g of t minus u into integral with respect to u. Okay. This is the convolution formula. Now I am going to one problem. The problem is here, apply the convolution theorem to find inverse Laplace transform of, see here, s divided by a squared plus a squared the whole square. You can find the convolution theorem of in this one. Okay. So the first you have to split into in this function. See here, the numerator s, you have to split s into 1. The denominator of in this one you can split into the two concept. See here, a squared plus a squared the whole square. Na, see in this one, L inverse of in this s divided by right this a squared plus a squared. And then here, see in this L inverse inside of in this bracket. So here you can put the star because this is the convolution concept. So here you can put the star. Here L inverse of 1 divided by a squared plus a squared. See here, yes, you have to split s into 1. The denominator, the whole square, you have to split the s squared plus a squared, a squared plus a squared. Okay, right? So the next one, L inverse of s by a squared plus a squared. What is the formula? Already we know that the Laplace of L of cos a t. What is the formula? S divided by a squared plus a squared. This one is the basic formula for the Laplace. But what do you want? You want the L inverse of. See here, in this L can be written as the right hand side. Now cos a t is equal to L inverse of like this. See here, L inverse of in this one, we have to take cos a t. Use the formula. Next put star. L inverse of 1 by a squared plus a squared. See, we know that L of sin a t divided by a divided by a squared plus a squared. But what do you want? You want 1 divided by like this. So a is the constant. So no problem. So in this one, you can take sin of a t equal to L inverse of a divided by a squared plus a squared. This a is the constant. So is this constant can be written as the left hand side now? 1 divided by a. So L inverse of in this one, you can put sin a t divided by a. Okay. So the next one, using this formula. So what is the formula here? Integral 0 to t. See, the first function you can change u. Is it right? So here you can take cos a u. The second one into g of t minus u. See, the, what is the second one? Sin a. The second function t, you can change t minus u. See here t, you can change t minus u. Whole thing divided by a. This is integral with respect to du. Okay, va? So the next one, see, the denominator value a is the constant. So here you can take 1 by a, 0 to t, write this one, cos a u into sin a into t minus u into du. Okay, so the next, you can apply the formula of in this one. How can you apply the formula? See here, we know that the formula in your lower class, you have to study about the formula. What is the formula? Sin a plus b. What is the formula for sin a plus b? Ma? So here, sin a cos b plus, here plus in a plus, cos a sin b. Okay, here you can use in this formula. What is the another formula? The another formula is sin a minus b. Okay, what is the formula of in this one? Sin a cos b, here minus enough, here you can put minus cos a sin b. See here, what do you want? You want cos a sin b. See here, cos a sin b you want, now you can A plus B sin A minus B. You want cos A sin B, sin A cos A sin B here also. You want F in this concept. Now you have to subtract F in this one. See, sin of A plus B minus sin of A minus B is equal to, cancel out the first term, you will get the second term 2 times cos A sin B. Okay, cos A sin B. See here, you want cos A sin B only. Okay, so in this 2 can be written as the left hand side. So it will become 1 divided by in this 2, 2A integral 0 to T. Okay, well, the next one. See, 2 cos A sin B, this 2 can be written as the left hand side. Okay, well, the next one cos A. So here cos A. See, sorry. 2 cos A sin B. Nah? In this one you can use the left hand side formula sin A plus B. Is it right? So here you can put sin A. What is A value? AU. The next plus B. What is B value? See here, plus AT minus AU. Is it right? So sin A plus B. What is the next one? Minus sin A minus B. Sin A minus B. What is A here? AU minus B. What is B? Minus B. So here minus AT plus AU. Okay? Minus AT plus AU into DU. Okay? So the next one, integrating in this one, you will get the result. Okay? So how can you integrate of in this one? Here cancel the AU, AU. Okay? Well, so the next one, cancel the AU, AU. In this one, AU plus AU, 2AU. So we have to write is equal to 1 divided by 2A. See this integral 0 to T sin AT. Okay? So write sin AT plus, what is here? Sorry, here minus. Is it right? So here you can put minus AU, AU, 2AU. So minus of sin 2AU. And then this is minus AT. Is it right? So minus AT. And then here du. What is the next one? You have to integrate of in this one, you will get the result. Okay, what is the integration of in this one? Integral with respect to u. Is it right? So here integral with respect to u. Now this is called a sin at. Is it right? So what is the integration of in this one? See, 1 by 2a sin at integration is cos at. But what do you want? You want integral with respect to u. Okay, so here sin at is the constant. So sin AT is the constant. In this u, du, integral with respect to u, now you will get a u. Substitute the limit value 0 to t minus, see this sin theta. What is the sin theta integration? What is the sin theta integration? The sin theta integration is minus cos theta. So minus into minus plus here cos theta. What is the theta? AU, 2AU minus AT. The next one you have to differentiate up to this one, that is the denominator value. With respect to u, 2A is the constant, right? U with respect to u, 1, the constant value is 0. So here also you can put the limit value 0 to t. Okay? So the next one here, 1 by 2A. Yeah, substitute the upper limit, t minus u, is it right? So, t minus 0, you will get the t. So, in this t can be written as in front of in this one, t into sin a t plus 1 by 2a is the constant, right? The substitute the upper limit, t, 2a t minus a t, is it right? So, what is 2a t minus a t? A t minus lower limit, put u equal to 0. So, here cos of minus a t, is it right? So what is the cos of minus theta? We know that cos theta. Sin of minus theta, minus sin theta. See, 1 divided by 2a, write this t into sin at plus 1 divided by 2a, see cos at minus, cos of minus theta value is cos theta. So here you can put the cos at. Okay, see here cos at negative, cos at. So this is cancel. So you will get 1 by 2a of 0. So the final answer is 1 by 2a t into sin at. Hence the proof. Thank you.